There is certainly large differences in the extent to which people experience racism in Australia. So Indigenous people experience some of the highest levels of racism. It depends on the survey that we've done. Some national surveys say something like 27% of Indigenous people are experiencing racism at least once a year. And other more local area surveys have much higher results. And I guess the important thing to note is really the range of experiences that people are having. As I mentioned before, it can be feeling excluded, being abused on the street, and even some of the more extreme forms of racism, things you'd think of as not very common, seem to be happening a lot. So, for example, a quarter of Indigenous people in a study that we did here in Victoria were experiencing racism as being spat at or having something thrown at them by other people at least once a year. So they're very confronting, kind of blatant forms of racism that are mixed in with much more common forms of kind of racist abuse and exclusion and feelings of being out of place and being told by people that they don't really belong in the local area where they come from.
And is there anything that people can do to protect themselves from racism having these negative impacts on their health?
Mm. That's a good question. We need to do a lot more research on that. Individual responses do seem to make a difference. So I guess importantly, people should feel able to make a response to racism, whether it is in the moment or whether it's later on when they seek social support from their friends or colleagues or report it to authorities or what have you. It's really, the evidence now is just about taking some sort of action in response to racism rather than trying to ignore it predominantly or trying to pretend it doesn't happen or starting to feel like you have to avoid places in everyday life because of those experiences. It's really important to try and do something about it as it kind of relieves the stress of racism. But I mean, more broadly than that, obviously there's much work to do in terms of actually stopping racism from happening in the first place.
There have been calls for the government to step in here and acknowledge and address this issue, but what can they do? What would you like governments to do?
Well, at the moment we do have a national anti-racism strategy called Racism It Stops With Me, and racism is noted as a very important factor in the new national Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander health plan, which is in place for the next 10 years. So there really is already some initiatives in place that I think more people need to sign on to. Organisations, businesses, local governments and individuals go to these campaigns and think about what they can do and reflect, I guess, on whether they're implicated in some of this racism that happens or whether they've seen it happen and perhaps could do more to address it.